Hi and welcome to my new programming series on OpenGL ES3. My aim is to teach you how to code ES3 graphics using C++. I'll be using a Raspberry Pi 4, but the code should work on most Linux boxes with ES3 support. What we need to do first is to prepare our system for OpenGL ES3 development. That will involve downloading and installing a few software packages from the repository. At the end of this video, you will be able to create a blank window. We'll be using SDL for that, as it makes life much easier compared to, say, using X11 directly. Blank windows, I know, a bit underwhelming, but it's an absolutely crucial first step. Before we begin setting up our system, let me give you a sneak preview of what's to come in the coming weeks. In lesson 1, we'll be creating a basic SDL window. That's all there will be to it. In lesson 2, we'll write code to display a basic OpenGL hello world equivalent called hello triangle. In lesson 3, we'll learn how to specify additional attributes such as color, as shown here. And then we'll learn to combine vertex elements to draw more complex shapes, the first being a rectangle. Once we have mastered this, we'll create the cube. We'll then make the cube look more realistic by introducing perspective distortion. We'll also deal with capturing user input. As you can now see, you can start and stop the cube from rotating simply by pressing the space bar. Well, you can't see me pressing the space bar, but we'll show how everything is done in code. Lighting effects makes our simulated world look more real. We will start by implementing code for diffuse lighting, also known as Lambertian reflectance. We'll then up the ante by taking into account specular reflection using what is known as a full form shader. We'll then add more detail to our objects by painting them with images. These images are called textures, here a polka dot pattern, but you can use any image of your choice. Then it's on to more complex objects such as a sphere. We'll learn how to use a sky dome to create a more immersive environment. And finally, we'll look at special effects such as transparency. That, in a nutshell, is what we'll be doing in this introductory series. Depending on the response I get, I might do a more advanced series that looks at, say, scene graphs, sounds, loading Blender files, essentially laying the foundation for building a game engine. Okay, now, let's get started.